Hello friends, welcome back to next one. In this session we are going to discuss how we can automate GET request. So in previous session we have set up our project and we have created GET request automation class. So now I am going to add a test method here which is available from testng, and I am creating one method which is public called GET request automation. So we need to import testng, and as discussed earlier, so I have imported io.testratio.testratio.start. So all the classes by default will come, and this is again I have imported from matchup package. So for seamless experience, you can import these two packages before starting test. So now first we need to define our base URI or endpoint. To do that, we need to write rest assured, and it is coming here rest assured.io. And we need to define here base URI. So there are two options here, which is base URI and base path. So you can split it your URL. So in future we will see how we can split it, because our base URL will be changed. For let's say we are working on one environment, let's say staging environment or pre-prod environment or dev environment or test environment. So base URI will be changed, but base path will remain same. So in future session we will see how to play with base URI and base path. So initially we are going to use base URI. Base URI is equal to, we need to give our base URL here. So we are going to use this APIs. So this is open source and available to all. To use that, you need to go to this site, and here we can get all the APIs which is open source, and we can use any APIs, get, post, put, delete, each and every APIs are here. So here we are going to use the GET request. And using GET request, we will get this response. So here also postman, I have used GET request. So if I hit this, this is my base URI, and this is endpoint /API/users. And this page 2 parameter we have to pass. So if we send this, we can see the response here. Now we need to write rest assured.given. We need to pass our params. So whatever params value we need to pass here. So our param is page and value is 2. So we need to pass here param and value is 2. Then we need to write dot when dot get, because this is our GET request. So we need to write get dot then dot, we are going to assert our request. So we are going to actually assert API response. So dot assert that dot, we need to print our entire status, what are the response we are getting, we need to print that request. So we need to use log dot all. So it will print our request and then we'll assert the status code. So which is status code, if you do mouse over here, so before writing, so you can see here status code, it accept the int value. So we need to give here int value status code which is 200, and okay. So if I hit this, okay, so I can see here my test run is 1 and failure is 0, skip is 0. So my test is pass, it has hit on this request, and we have passed parameter 2. And we are getting this response, along with it is printed headers as well. So we are printing log all, so that's why it is printed entire header as well as response body. So this is one way. Now we are going to use another way, rest assured dot given dot param, we need to pass param which is our page value is 2 dot when, we are going to hit get request, so dot get, and we can get our response here. So this is response. So using this we need to create a local variable which is response. So in real time scenario, let's say we are going to use for single validation, but for all the APIs we cannot use this syntax. So after that we'll get the response, and using that response, whatever operations you wanted to do, we can do here. print this response, we can write response dot get body dot as string. If we run this, we can see here it has returned only response body, not an entire request. So this is one way to get the request body. Now we'll get the status code. So response dot get status code, we can get the status code here. This is our status code. After that we are going to print content type of our request. To do that we need to write response dot content type. So it will return what is the content, application.json or whatever. We can do using this syntax. Then we can get the time as well. We can write response dot get time. We can print the cookies as well. So whatever cookie this API is returning, we can print cookies. Cookies response dot get cookie. So there are two ways. So here first we need to give cookie name. So we can give a cookie name, specific cookie name. Otherwise, if we need all the cookies, so we can, there are one more syntax which is get cookies. So it is return the map object. So now we hit this, we can see here everything, our request got successful. And we can see here get status code which is 200, content type is application.json, time is 853 cookies. So this is the one cookie for this request. So we can get all the cookies here. So this four parameter we are going to print. Now we have seen here this request body is going to print plain text of our response. Now let's say you wanted to print in beautiful way or pretty JSON format, so you can do that as well. Response dot pretty print. So there is one method called pretty print, so that is also available in restreceive.io. So this all the methods are available in this library. So if I run this, so you can see here it will print in specific JSON format. So you can see here this is, it has printed and our test is passed. So there is no failure. Now we need to understand one more thing. So in real time usage, let me go to the YouTube and let me open the network tab, inspect element and network tab. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to search Fundo testers. Search and you can see here all the results are coming. Yes, so we can see here this is our search API. So whenever I search something on YouTube, I have searched Fundo tester, so this is my base URI. So up to result, this is my base URI and result is a, it might be endpoint as per the YouTube, and this is params. So whatever we have used here, page 2. So here params, it is going as a search query text and one, and another is PBJ means page 1. So you can see here these all are the parameter as a real time scenario. Two parameter, Fundo tester and PBJ is equal to 1. Now we have used for test API, but real scenario we need to pass request header as well. So let's say we are searching something, so we need to pass request headers as well, so along with the parameter. And there are too many request headers are going. So let's say some specific name or content type, but there might be few are mandatory, few are not, but we are sending some request headers and we have two parameters here. You can see a Fundo tester and PBJ1. So here we have used one parameter. So in future sessions we are going to see, let's say we have multiple params or multiple get headers, multiple headers, so how we can dynamically handle, because each and every API, let's say this you are going to use for page number 2, Now we need to test for page number 3 or any other parameter. So every time you cannot come here and you cannot change, and after that you cannot run your test. So this will be tedious task. So we'll see how we can handle it dynamically. So if you are going to use for post API, so let's say post API, we need to pass headers and body. So in body also parameters are going to change. So for that time we need to go with multi headers dynamic approach. So in further sessions we can learn how we can handle our post and get request with dynamic parameters and dynamic headers or dynamic body. Thank you guys, thanks for watching the video.